फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू लर्न एंड एक्सप्लोर। होप यू ऑल आर फाइन। आई विश अ गुड हेल्थ टू यू एंड योर फैमिली अगेंस्ट दिस COVID-19 पेंडेमिक। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट ओपन ट्रावर्स करेक्शन इन लैंड सर्विंग इन दिस वीडियो। ऑल्सो वी हैव प्रिपेयर्ड एन एक्सेल बेस्ड सॉफ्टवेयर फॉर ओपन ट्रावर्स करेक्शन। ओके, सो बिफोर शेयरिंग द एक्चुअल शीट आई वॉन्ट टू रिक्वेस्ट यू टू वॉच the full video so that you can use the Excel sheet without any problem. Before starting our video, I want to request you all please to subscribe our channel, and if you think that this video will help you, please do like, share and comment so that other also can get help from this video. Now I will give basic concept about open traverse and how field data have been obtained and what are the corrections we apply in open traverse surveying. Basically, in closed traverse surveying, we start collecting data from a point and finally return to the same point, right? This we make a polygon closed traverse. For correction of closed traverse, we already shared an Excel sheet which is available in our channel's link. If you need the same, then you check it out from our channel playlist, right? Now in open traverse, we start surveying from a known point to another known point. Okay, in modern surveying, two pair of known points are used in open traverse surveying, which have been set by the DGPS. That means Differential Global Positioning System. Total station have been used to take measurements of intermediate points. Due to several factors like instrumental error or any other error, weather, humidity, anything, the total station data need correction, right? In this Excel sheet, we apply Boyd-Dutch rule and used for the correction of open traverse data. This is our open traverse line diagram. With the help of this line diagram, I will explain the basic concept behind the open traverse theory. Okay, so here you can see GPS 1, GPS 2, GPS 3 and GPS 4 points. These points are taken by DGPS and also corrected by DGPS, and these points are known to us. That means this is a known coordinates. Okay, and with the help of total station, we will take the intermediate points between this GPS points. Okay, these intermediate points are basically taken for setting up the temporary benchmark of any projects, such as road projects, railway projects and any other projects. Okay, and this total station setup, these are oriented by this known station points. Okay, we will shifting the total station many more places because of the intervisibility from one station. Okay, and at first we are setting up our total station in station 1. This is okay in station 1, and we are oriented our total station by this GPS 1 and GPS 2 point, and from this setup we are taking the intermediate point P1 and P2. Okay, after taking these points, other points are invisible, so we are setting up our total station in station 2. Okay, and this setup is oriented by station 1. After setting up our total station in station 2, we are taking point 3 and point 4. In this way, we are taking all the intermediate point, and lastly we set up our total station here, and we taking this known points GPS 3 and GPS 4 points with the help of our total station because of the correction. we will find out the deviation between the GPS points with the help of total station data taking. Okay, and on behalf of that deviation, we will apply our open traverse correction, which is made by us in an Excel sheet manner. Now, one of our team expert will tell you how the correction are done through Excel.
Hello friends, myself Soman Samanta. Now I will show you how to use our Excel sheet for open traverse correction. So this is the Excel sheet what we have prepared. Now I have some sample data which have been collected from the field. Okay, so you can see that these are the starting points taken by DGPS, GPS1 and GPS2, and these are the ending points, GPS3 and GPS4. These all are the known points. We know the coordinates of these points. Now these are the intermediate points, P1, P2, P3, like this, and we have taken GPS3 and GPS4 data also with the help of ETS as described before. Okay, so now with the help of this field data, I will correct this intermediate data by the help of our Excel sheet. So what you have to do is you have to copy this point ID string ordering of first pair of points, first known pair of points. Just copy it and go to the Excel sheet, and here you can see the starting known point. You have to paste the data here. Okay, then again for ending known point, we will copy the ending known points, that is GPS3 and GPS4. So copy it and going to Excel sheet, right click, paste as value. So we have pasted these starting known points and the ending known points. Now we have to input the survey data of intermediate points. You can see point ID, easting and northing. So we have this data. Copy this data. Copy and going to my Excel sheet. Just right click and paste as value. Now you can see that output has been generated. These are the corrected string ordering for this open traverse. Now you can see the delta string. I'll show you. In our data, you can see that GPS3 known point of GPS3 is like this. But when we collected this GPS3 data by the ETS, there is a variation. So this variation in string and ordering, that is delta string and delta ordering, is divided in the intermediate points with respect to its cumulative distance. Okay, you can find that this line length, bearing, cumulative length, okay, correction in easting and correction in northing. So you have to just copy and paste your data and this output will be generated automatically. And you can see this delta easting and delta northing is adjusted in each point with respect to its cumulative length. Okay, and one more thing, you must have to take the data of GPS3 and GPS4 with the help of ETS, and also this GPS3 and GPS4, this point ID must match with this intermediate points. Okay, otherwise our Excel sheet will not work. Hope you guys understood what I have shown here. Okay, and I have given the downloaded link in the comment section. You can download it. Thank you guys for watching this video. Hope it will help you in your surveying work. See you in the next video. Bye bye. Thank you.